Okay, so we are here to learn about real numbers. All right, so this is the topic which is the fundamental of class 10th, and we are going to go step by step. All right, so let's start. Okay, so let me just take you over here. See, now first of all, what are real numbers? Right, so see, real numbers are nothing but it constitutes rational and irrational numbers. Okay, now what are rational numbers, what are irrational numbers? All this you have already studied in class number 9, but still, just to frame up on this, I can just say the number in the form of P by Q is known as the rational number. All right. Now, when you go further on this topic, the next thing which you learn is you learn about Euclid's division lemma. This is the basics of your class 10th, or you can say, you know, the easiest and the most used method till now. So now we will discuss about our Euclid's division lemma. All right. Now what are we going to do here? See, Euclid's division lemma states that given two integers a and b, right? So if suppose there are integers a and b, there exists a unique pair of integers. Maybe you can say Q and R. So you have Q and R such that what happens? See, this is the equation which will be used all the time. B into Q plus R. Right. Okay. Now you have to be very careful. This R which we are talking about, it has to be greater than 0. But less than b. So then only this condition will appear. And if you observe this very carefully, have you ever seen this kind of formula? See, we are using the same formula from many years. It's just the difference of writing. We are writing in the Euclid's division lemma. We are giving a new name in class 10. But this is essentially equivalent to what? Now see, can you remember something? See, dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So that's what we are trying to say. This is dividend, this is your divisor, this is your quotient, and this is your remainder. And if you see, or if we say, in other words, for a given pair of dividend and divisor, the quotient and the remainder obtained are going to be unique. So don't you think this we've been learning from long time? All right. So Euclid's division lemma is clear to you. It is nothing, but you can just say that it states that the given two integers a and b, there exists a unique pair. Unique pair of what? Q and R. These are also integers. And such that. So it is, you just have to remember this. All right. So we are writing, suppose dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. This thing in the new form, that's all. Okay, now what will I do is, this was Euclid's division lemma. Now I'm going to take you to its algorithm. So now the new thing which I'm talking about is Euclid's, then I will say division algorithm. Okay. Now, first of all, tell me, what is an algorithm? Algorithm is nothing but the steps of doing something. And obviously, when you are applying this formula, there has to be a purpose, and that purpose we need steps to solve it. So here, this Euclid's division algorithm is a method used to find HCF of two numbers, right? So very, very important. It is used for finding the HCF of A and B, say. But here, you have to be very, very careful. A should be greater than B. Now, this is the first condition. Now, second thing. We apply Euclid's division lemma to find two integers, Q and R. So, now you have again know what we learnt or what we did just now. That was B into Q plus R. So, first step is, this is used to take out the HCF or find the HCF of two numbers. Second, we apply the Euclid's division lemma, that is A is equal to B into Q plus R, wherein you already know that R should be greater than 0 and less than B. Okay. Then the third condition. Suppose if your R is equal to 0, then what are we going to do? The HCF is B. Why? Because see, this is anyways 0. So what is happening in this case? If this is 0, that means the HCF becomes equal to B. Right? We apply this Euclid's division lemma to B divisor and the remainder to get another pair of quotient and remainder. Right? So definitely the purpose over here is very, very clear. Right? The purpose is the above method is repeated until a remainder of 0 is obtained. The divisor in that step is the HCF of the given set of numbers. So this has to continue till what? Till we get the remainder as 0. Now what do I mean by this? This is very complicated. I've told you everything like this. But what do I want to say? What is the purpose of saying over here? Okay. Now what I'll do is, I'm going to explain you by an example. Right? Okay. So let me give you one example over here. Alright. Suppose we say that you have to find the LCM. The question is, find the LCM of say 18 and 30. Suppose you have to find. Now what are the steps which you will follow for Euclid's division algorithm? Alright. Now see. Look at it very, very carefully. Alright. So see, suppose this is 30. I'm going very slow for all of you. Okay. And here we are dividing by 18. Right. So this is my step 1. Okay. Now what will I do? The number which I will put over here is 18 banza 18. Right. Now when you minus this, you are left with 10 minus 2, 10 minus 8 is 2 and 2 minus 1 is 1. So this is 12. Alright, now you have to be very careful. See, this one we have already got. Now what we want is this thing. This is what? This is the remainder in step 1. Right? So this is your remainder in step 1. Correct. But here what will happen in step 2, here comes your step 2. Now 12 will divide. What it will divide? It will divide 18. Why? Because 18 is the divisor in step 1. Okay. Now again the same thing. Which I will do 12 ones are 12. So we are left with nothing but, yes, 6 I guess. Alright. Now same thing will happen. Step 3. If you say, alright. If you say, we will say that 6, this is what? This is the remainder in step 2, right? If this is the remainder in step 2, what are we going to do? We'll put 12. Now 12 is what over here? 12 is the divisor in step 2. So here this becomes your divisor in step 2. Okay. Now same thing we will do. 6 2's are 12. Wherein when you answer, divide it, you get answer as 0. Here what happens? Here you get the remainder as 0. Right. Now when the remainder is 0 in step 3, the divisor in step 3 is the HCF. So what we will say? We will say that this number, see, here we are getting a remainder 0. So that means this is the HCF of 18 and 13. This number 6. Right? So if we have to answer this question, we can say the required HCF is 6. Alright. So now I think the algorithm algorithm which I was talking about is clear to you now. Right. Now second thing is, I think this is very clear to you about the Euclid thing. Secondly, if you see what are the applications of HCF and LCM in the real world problem, see, LCM can be used to find the points of common occurrence. For example, like ringing of bells with different frequencies. Suppose two of the people are, having a race, running at different speeds, and then they meet up soon. Regarding the traffic lights. So you have various applications, uses of HCF and LCM in the real world thing. So thank you so much. I hope you've enjoyed my session. Thank you. Bye-bye. Press on the bell icon to subscribe my channel. Thank you.